the auto space and the auto ancillary space takes focus. Auto sales have failed to pick up momentum in the month of February despite deep discounting and promotional offers. And that can't be good news for ancillary industry as well. One such player which has a very big presence in the axle space is GNA Axles. So has the slowdown been just a temporary blip, or is it going to be a longer lasting phenomenon? Joining us to talk a little bit more about this in greater detail is the president and CEO, Mr. Ranbir Singh. Mr. Singh, thanks very much for taking out the time. I just want to put into perspective with regards to what you did in quarter three. So your domestic revenues grew significantly on the back of a relatively high volume that came in from the NHCV goods segment. Now that we're seeing a slightly more shift in the dynamics of the volume growth numbers from within the auto space, is that number going to get affected materially at your end?
Divina, good morning. Thanks for inviting me. As far as Q3 numbers, our numbers were very strong in domestic for CV and for tractor segment. Unfortunately, from January onwards, the overall volumes and the production, everybody has dropped by 20 to 25%. No doubt on the sales, there's a drop in Ashok Leyland and all in Q3, 7% plus. And in, from January to March, again, their sales is affected by 10%, but production drop is by 20 to 25%. As so far as GNA is concerned, as you know, our dependency is over 50% on export on North America, Europe, Asia, then South America also, or different regions are there. So our top line is not affected.
Right. No, so since you're mentioning North America, the overall orders from North America have been gradually declining as well. So I'm just going to pick it up from the highest point, I think, which was somewhere during mid-2018, where the number was closer to 52,000 odd. It's dropped to about 16,700 in the month of Feb 2019. So isn't that also affecting you slightly negatively?
No doubt in North America, class 8 category, class 7, 8, the heavy segment is dropping. But because we are not only in class 8, we are in from class 8 to class 6, that is medium segment. We are in large in that segment also. We are in class 7 and 8 also. Overall increase in our North American sales is over 60% as compared to last year. Still, we are overbooked and we are compensating our this loss of sales in domestic market through our export.
So loss of sales, you said obviously production cuts have been taken to the tune of about 20-25%. So that translates into what for you in terms of loss of sales?
It has affected as far as within the domestic market, in value terms, the drop is over 20% in domestic in Q4. On other hand, in export, that gap is covered. So we are top line, we are maintaining or as far as near to Q3. This is the whole scene in our sales.
You are saying that there will be no negative implication when the quarter four numbers come out with regards to the top line, because what you're losing out in the domestic market, you're more than covering up in the export market, right?
Yes, exactly.
Okay. Let's talk about the industry right now and the pain points that we're witnessing at this juncture, Mr. Singh. And what is your sense as to when do you see the turnaround of this happening? Because, you know, while we're looking at production cuts of 20 to 25%, like you yourself highlighted, I mean, this doesn't change anytime soon. So in light of that, what is the recourse measure that, you know, a player like yourself needs to take to maintain earnings momentum growth?
Actually, in domestic market, the industry is going through a lot of headwinds, you know. So it is affecting the overall scenario by 25% clear cut, which is visible in every segment, you know, in two-wheelers, in auto sector, purely auto sector. Even Maruti has dropped over 26% production in March to take the correction in the stocks, in the finished stocks. But this scene will continue, according to my opinion, in auto segment and CV segment in first quarter also. But on other end, the tractor market, that is off-highway segment, it will improve from April onwards, because there is a season from April to July. There's a harvesting season, and we are getting now schedules for April production also. So that will, there will be improvement in tractor segment, but we have no hope from auto and CV segment in Q1.
Okay. From the tractor segments, you know, so far, what has been the amount of executable orders on a monthly basis?
Tractor is similarly like other segments in Q4 this year has affected. It is a totally clear-cut production losses. They are not producing. They are producing less by 20 to 25%. But overall tractor market growth will be, this year will be around 10%.
Mm. Okay. 10% growth in the tractor market. Could you give me a status of your order book position, if at all?
This year our overall growth will be over 35%, as we have given you earlier this guidance also, and our sales will be over 900 crores, and that constitutes to 35% plus. And in coming year also, we are planning to grow between 10 to 15%. That is a very conservative growth, because after seeing the total scenario of domestic market.
So, I mean, for next year, the entire year, you've given only 15 odd percent. Are you expecting this pain to continue longer within the domestic market?
We can't say anything, because this is the election year, and after May only, the position will be clear. You know, this is too early to say anything on this.
Okay. Aside from that, would you be able to maintain your margin trajectory of about 15-16%?
Yes, we are maintaining margins between 15 to 16%. That bottom line is maintained, and we have lot many in-house cost reduction and other projects, and we are maintaining our bottom line.
Mm. All in all, you know, while obviously, you know, you're reserving your comments with regards to the pain points in the domestic market, export market growth, 10%, is that something that you highlighted before? Are you expecting that to continue?
There are two reasons, Devina, because in North America and Europe, a lot of shift of business will be there to India to cut their costs. You know, it is not like that. All growth in India for export, not only depending upon their market size, but on the shift of business also, what they want to offload in future. So that also depends.
But is this a visible trend, this weakness across, not just India? I mean, you're seeing that as a result of your export orders too?
Yes, we are very hopeful in coming financial year also, we'll be able to grow in export by 15 to 20% minimum.
Okay. So just one last question before we wind up, with regards to whether or not, while obviously production cuts have been happening within the industry, at your level, at your company level, are you scaling back? With regards to, you know, your capacity utilization, are you looking to reduce that in any fashion to make sure that you don't overproduce right now in a period which looks like a lull?
It's not like that. We are tapping more customers over there. We have no agenda to reduce our capacity enhancement. In coming year also, we are enhancing our capacity by 25%.
Okay, got that. Mr. Singh, thanks so very much for joining us. Appreciate you taking
out
the time.
Thank you.